Hello guys, and welcome to episode 4 of Utopia Cubed 2.0 Age of Adventure. Yes, very cool. As you guys can see, I have been busy between the episodes. Like always, doing some very cool stuff, preparing a lot, making sure that I skip the boring parts, do the fun parts on camera, and that is exactly what I got planned for this episode, of course. So, as you guys can see, first of all, I cleared out mainly the entire island. All the trees, everything is gone. All the mountains, fixed it all up with grass and everything. And I can show you guys while flying in bat mode. That is just looking awesome. I still need to fill this in with dirt, but other than that, it's still already looking awesome. Like, as you guys can see right now, it will be awesome. Just imagine like this entire island, more buildings over there or right there, maybe something cool in the middle, maybe like some sort of massive tower somewhere, all kinds of cool magic stuff, and just, yeah, tons of cool stuff in general. Then also what you guys can see is I fixed up the sorting room. I pretty much put all the lockers in here and, you know, made some signs and sorted out all my junk, which is quite a lot, but now it's finally done and it will save me a lot of time going in the future, so that's gonna be good. I also fixed this all up, so I now got more space for a farm. I still have this for my mining shaft, but I will be moving that to somewhere, maybe make it like look a bit better. Clear this all out, so now it's, you know, all cool and stuff. I got my smelter set up here, moved it all to one specific place. I got my rapier upgraded to skill level master. I got this, I got all my tools with auto repair, and I put a, what's it called again? The quicksilver, that's called. Quicksilver hat on this pickaxe, so it mines incredibly fast, which is awesome. So, I got for this episode a couple of things planned. First of all, as you guys can see, I collected myself some obsidian and I think it would be time to do some interdimensional traveling. Yes, I think it would be about time, episode 4 already, so, you know, we already got a nether portal that spawned, but I of course would like my own private nether portal. So let's see, let's fire it up. Ooh. Let's see what awaits on the other side. Okay. Apparently, I accidentally joined up on the spawn that some people have already made. So, honestly, the return part will be a bit annoying, but other than that, I think we got ourselves a decent spawn place. So, let's see. I should fix this up, though, to make it actually work, you know, coming to my island soon. But for now, I got myself a nice system to travel across dimensions. So yeah, should be fine. So let's see what I can do without instantly dying. Button. I was thinking like, where on earth? I guess what I can do is, as a ghost. No, wait, hold on. I know what I need to do. I don't happen to have any wood on me. Let's quickly head back. Store my stuff, because in case I die, I don't want to lose, like, much stuff. Or hopefully nothing at all, honestly. So I will quickly... Is there some wood anywhere nearby? Yes, there is. Let me then make a chest for myself. There we go. And is there also a sign somewhere, just in case I am gone for a little bit longer? Stick or two, and I need myself some wood. Nowhere. Oh well, then I guess what I will do is quickly, you know. I guess I'm gonna just put it like right here for now. Shouldn't be fine. Put all my stuff in there, so I don't want to lose anything that has the slightest bit of value to me. So that's what I will do. Watering can, sure don't need that. Yeah, all stuff that I don't need right now on me. So that should be good. So let's head back, see what I can find in the nether, and hopefully make some markings for the next time that I get back here. so I can do some fancy stuff. So let's see. We got torn vines, and oh wow, they hurt quite a lot. Of course, tons of lava lakes, as to be expected from the Nether. What's this? Flame string and a pile of ash, which is also pretty cool. Got some berries, sure, I'll take those. And oh, one of those very fast exploding creeper thingies that I absolutely hate, even though I am a creeper. Wait, no, I'm a bat with a redstone thingy on his head. Let's see, a grave. I do need to keep in Wabi. I do need to keep track of though where our spawn is, but oh, please don't kill me, stupid bee. Honestly, in real life, I am afraid as can be of bats, or wasps, sorry. So them being in Minecraft does not really please me, honestly. let's see, is there anything good to be found here? And oh wow, that just randomly spawned in front of me. Seriously, get alive, you freaking wasp thingy. And that's not a wasp, that's a wisp. It's still stalking me. Let's see, what is this? I'm not even sure what all that kind of stuff is about. It does look quite cool, honestly. But what I'm currently looking for is if I can find some sort of nether plants or something. I am fairly certain we have those. That means like we can grow blaze rods and I believe even glowstone up to a certain point, honestly. So yeah, that should be pretty cool if I find some of those. And honestly, if I die right now, it's not a big deal because, well, I don't have much stuff on me, just some apples. But of course, I hope I don't die. Nothing really interesting to see here. Oh, well. There is a... Yeah. Cool. There's a blaze spawner right here. I'm not sure if it has been looted already. If it hasn't, then I will certainly let everyone know the coordinates. But I'm fairly certain it has been an Undertaker. No clue what it is. But apparently it's some sort of chest. Hey, potatoes. Wow. Random chests of some sort, I guess. I don't know. I'm not complaining. Yeah. Pretty cool stuff. So, what I will do is probably see if I can find my way back. At least I know though that I got myself a cool way of getting to the Nether and back. And found myself already some interesting stuff right here. So it should be good. And I will meet you guys in just a minute. And as to be expected, I died by a ghast. Yay for flying creatures that can bomb me with freaking fireballs while I only have 3 health left. So yeah, quickly went back to spawn to pick up all my stuff. So yeah, now I will be able to do a lot more other cool stuff. So my plan was to actually get into a bit more modded Minecraft today. Mainly when saying modded Minecraft, I mean Magic Minecraft, which will be very cool. So yeah, let me do some preparation work and I will meet you guys in a minute. Okay, so before I get started, I quickly want to show you guys one thing. In the quest book, pretty much, if I would start and click show quests, pretty much you guys will see that I unlocked these 3 professions. Because pretty much I completed the professions quest and got one merchant item, which is pretty cool. One of these thingies, so that's pretty nice. And pretty much that allowed me to choose one of these 3, and I have already chosen, as you guys can see, since I have the magic user profession 20% complete. Yes, Pretty much it gave me the magic user brew stand, which only allows me to unlock this one. So pretty much you have to choose one of four professions. And I choose magic because I'm planning on doing magic a lot this series. So let's see. I can pick a reward, either the Tamanomicon, the Sacrificial Knife, the Lexica Botania, and the Witchcraft Collecting Fumes. So let's see. What's the Collecting Fumes book? That's not too bad. The knife is a piece of gold and iron. I know how to make a Tamanomicon and a Lexica Botania. Lexica Botania is just a sapling and a book. Well, then I guess what I will do is select myself the Sacrificial Knife just for the purpose of having awesome stuff going. So yeah, it should be pretty cool. And there we go, one Sacrificial Knife. But honestly, that is not the mod that I want to get started with, no. Simply because, well, I've done Blood Magic in the past, and I think later on it will be a lot better to actually do. But the mod that I do actually want to get started with is indeed Witchery, yes. So, let's see, I will need to create myself one of these books, which is a normal book, a Belladonna flower. Do I got any of those flowers? Or do I need Belladonna seeds or something for that? It's been a while, so I'm not quite sure anymore. Cotton, Belladonna seeds. Ah, yes. Apparently I need to get myself... What on earth is that? What? Was it just like some sort of super spider or something? That was really scary. Wow. Let's see. Let's quickly plant two of these. Get myself a watering can out. And just very quickly grow these two. The watering can is really an amazing tool for this. It's just all manual though, so yeah. Cool. There we go. Only need one of those for now. So it should be nice. Quickly run back, of course. Let's see. Collecting fumes. A book, a feather, a black dye, and one of those other thingies. Let's see. Where do I store paper? I think, yeah, there we go. Now I need a piece of leather. Then I need a piece of coal. Right. No, charcoal. A feather and a ink sack. Ink sack, feather. There we go. Easy as that. Put this together. One of these. And I got myself a Witchcraft Collecting Fumes book. And what on earth? What was that? What? I think it has something to do with the nether portal that I currently got sitting open. Let's just, for the sake of not wanting to be bombarded with other freaking mobs, let's turn this portal off for now. And I know there's some sort of glitchy mob underneath that, but I'll fix it later. But wow, that was like strange and scared me out. Cool. Witchcraft Collecting Fumes. Nice. So pretty much this will teach me exactly how I use the witchery stuff. So for that I will need a couple of things. First of all, I need a witch's oven. Then possibly a fume tunnel. And well, since it's a little bit expensive, I can also make it later. So it shouldn't be too much of an issue. So let's see. Honestly, I will only need some iron for this. And I should be smelting some more iron up right now, hopefully. I'm not quite sure if I actually made it to do that. Let's see. Witch's oven. There we go. Let me quickly sleep through the night and I will be right back. Okay. So, I got myself the witch's oven. And I'm currently cooking up some clay pots, as you guys can see right there. So, just for now, I will, you know, put it down somewhere not too far. I mean, it's only temporarily for now, so it should be good. If you look in the recipes, you guys can see that I am able to create myself a bunch of cool things. Mainly talking about stuff like these things that actually require the clay jar, which is also currently what I am after. But to progress just a bit, I will need myself some mutandis, which is wood ash, bone meal, cactus green, mandrakes, and hint of rebirth, which is spruce saplings. I'm not sure if I actually got any spruce saplings or any nearby, honestly. So I will probably just hold off with that for now and do that later. But I should be able to cook up some wood in this thing to get myself wood ash, I believe. Or how does one get wood ash? Let's quickly see if I can find it somewhere in here. There we go. Oh, it's just smelting saplings, I guess. That's useful. Which is what I will do now then, I guess. Quickly get myself some of this stuff out. There we go. So, I am able to do myself a couple of other things though, I guess. Wait. I should honestly do it in here so I can get the exhale of the horned one. Not sure if I, you know, actually need that. But I guess what doesn't kill me. Cool. Let's see. I don't think there's a big chance of getting that stuff, but there is a slight chance, so that might be pretty interesting. So let's see. What can I use stuff like this for? This will give me the exhale of the horned one, which can be used to make. Ooh, voodoo stuff. Always nice. Definitely something I want to get into soon. But one of the things that I would like to get myself is circle magic, which requires myself a whiff of magic, which requires a rowan sapling, which is why I need myself to attend this, which, as you guys can see, will require me to do a couple more steps. So, is there any way for me to actually turn these saplings into, I don't know, any other type of sapling? And pure seeds. Not sure what those do, honestly. Wow, those are a bunch of saplings, and I don't think I got a way to actually convert this stuff, which is a shame. Oh well. And hey, I got myself two exhales of the horned one. I should also be able to get myself the other type of saplings. Birch saplings, in that case. And once I do this, let's cook this up. And this should get me Breath of the Goddess. And Breath of the Goddess is used for leaping lily pads, which sounds pretty cool. And distilling, which is definitely something I want to get after this one. So that might be interesting. So I can actually get things like the Whiff of Magic through that way, apparently. Oh, hey, that might be a very good way of doing stuff, honestly. So let's see. How does one create a distillery? Let's see, can I find it in here somewhere, or do I need to actually type to look it up? I'm either being blind or I can't find it. Distillery. Ah, there we go. Clay jar is an attuned stone, which also requires the whiff of magic. Ah, so I guess I really need to get the rowan sapling first, which requires me to get myself some birchwood. So, let me quickly gather some of that and... Oh, hold on. Was I really like saying like I don't know where to find it? Well, I got myself a birchwood forest right next door. Wow. That's like... Really? Wow. I was being crazy. Crazy talk, Orch. Stop saying crazy talk. Let's get myself a couple of these saplings, hopefully. Let's get one of these. Tall tree. Should be good to get started with. And coconuts. Huh. And, oh wow, those are scary things. Please don't touch me. So yeah, I found a lucky villager on the side of a mountain and he has OP trage. Epic. Yeah, that sounds pretty interesting, honestly. So, let's see, please eat some of this stuff, nom nom nom. And I got some of this, let me burn up these. There we go. So now what I can also do probably is, since I got some of these seeds, which I will definitely need to plant down, pretty much, oh, wait, let me, where's my hoe, actually? I can't hoe with this thing, can I? A hatchet? No, I need to make the combined tool for that, so sadly I do not have that. Derp, all the derps. Where's my... I was fairly certain I got a hoe somewhere. No? Huh. Oh well. Let's make one out of iron. There we go. Hopefully this one will last a little bit longer. So let's see. It shouldn't be too hard, honestly. Since I only need to plant a couple of these to get started. And just to do the preparations for all this kind of stuff. And, oh wait, I need to place watery artichokes on that. This can go right there. Mandrakes can go in front of that. And then I also... Is that all I got? Water artichokes, mandrakes, and... Wait, what are these seeds? Oh yeah, and belladonna flowers. I guess that's all I got for now. Oh well, still pretty cool. So, what I guess I will do is wrap up the episode for now. Since this will take me some time to get going completely. I will turn this into, you know, some attendees and all that kind of cool stuff, which I should be able to get soon or later. So, should be all cool. I will also probably do some basic designing of how I want to actually lay out a dedicated room for all the witchery stuff. So that should be pretty cool too. And I hope to see you guys all next time.